Hi, it's Jason from Feature Radiators, and today we're going to take a look at specifically joining cast iron radiators, but the video is also applicable to sectional, aluminium and steel column radiators. So when you order a radiator, it might be too big to be delivered in one piece, so it could be delivered in two or three chunks, for example, to join together on site. So, as an example, if you order something like this cast iron radiator, this is a 10 section radiator. So, if you ordered a 30 section, it might be delivered in three lots of 10 sections for those to be put together on site. It's a relatively straightforward process to do, which we're going to take a look at for you now. If you order your radiator from Feature Radiators, we do provide you with step-by-step comprehensive instructions with pictures, and we also have a dedicated technical helpline, so if you have any questions you can always give us a call. So with cast iron radiators, what you've got in between the sections is a nipple and a gasket that's used to join the sections together. So what I'm going to do is bring this a little bit closer to the camera so you can see what I mean. So this is an example of a nipple, which is a metal part. You've opposed in threads, one's left hand, one's right hand. In the middle you've a gasket that gives you the seal, and inside of the nipple there's two little lugs there. Now what happens with those is this joining tool, which is also sometimes called a nipple key, goes in there, catches the lugs, and as you turn it, because of the opposing threads, it pulls the sections together. Alright, so I'm just going to move back and sort of carry on from there. So similarly with the radiators themselves, when you're joining them you need to make sure that you're joining the right pieces together. So one face is going to have a left hand thread and the other face is going to have a right hand thread, just like with the nipple. Right, so I'm going to take this piece here, try and screw it into the radiator so I can ascertain what I've got. Right, now when you're feeding these in, it might be a little bit tricky to start with, but you shouldn't force the piece in. Right, so if it's going in clockwise, it's a right hand thread. So what I'm going to do is just screw that in there. So as you can see, it's easy to do. If you feel a bit of resistance, it might just be a little bit of pain or something in the thread, so you might need to clean it a little bit. It's worthwhile while we're doing this just to wind it in a couple of times and out again, just to make sure that the threads are clear. So I'm going to do that on the other side there. Now we know which way to put the nipple into this side. Okay, we're looking for that side to have a left hand thread, so this should be able to turn anti-clockwise. So we're going to do the same thing with this side. Again, you shouldn't have to force it. Right, so that is going in anti-clockwise. So we know we've got the right other side of the radiator. Now we're going to do the same thing, wind it in and out a couple of times just to make sure the threads are clear. Do it the same on the other side. Right, so now we're going to take a look at making the join. A couple of things to remember before we do it. So make sure the faces that you're going to be joining are clean. If you're not sure or they look not quite clean, you can just go over it with a little bit of a light and abrasive. And also, because you've got the gasket in the middle of this nipple, you don't need to use PTFE tape or any sort of paste. That will give you the seal. Alright, so we're going to look at the join now. So what I'm going to do this time is I'm going to screw this in just so it catches, so not all the way in. There we go. You see it's grabbed the radiator. The other nipple, okay, what I'm going to do is I'm going to place a gasket over it, and that goes in the middle there. Okay, there's normally a little cutout in the middle, so you know where it's going to go anyway. And I'm going to do the same thing at the other side. Right, now we can see that's caught as well. So now I'm going to bring this side up to the hole there so that they're in line. Right. As you can see, it is important to make sure we're working on a flat and even surface to be able to do this. Alright, so now they're together. Okay, I'm going to hold that. Now we take the joining tool, and what we want to do is we want to make sure that the flat face is located about in the middle of the nipple. So a good way to do this is if we're looking at the top of the radiator, so you can see that it catches about there. So what I normally do is I put a bit of masking tape around that line so I know how far to go into the radiator. So from here, so we've got the till marked up and we know how far it needs to go into the radiator. So let's make the join. So I'm just going to roll these together and turn the till until we feel them knit together. So we know that side's caught, and then move to the other side. And then just bit by bit, that's caught as well. We're going to do one side at a time. Right, so what I've done with this radiator is I've tightened it up as far as I can tighten it to get it watertight. If you're lucky enough to have a torque wrench, you're going to tighten it to 200 newtons. But that's alright. So now it's joined, you'll know, if I show you the radiator, you've got holes in there where end bushes go. So these will come with the radiator as well. Again, you've got a gasket on the end bush, so there's no need to put PTFE tape sealant or anything on there. Okay, and we're just going to screw these into the side of the radiator. Again, there'll be a left hand or right hand specific. There we go. You can see that now they're now in there. And you'd have four in total altogether, but I've only got two just to show you how to get them in. Right, so that's your job done. I hope that you found the video useful. If you do have our radiators and you need any assistance, we do have a dedicated technical helpline, so you can always feel free to give us a call and we'll help you out. If you need to speak to us, please give us a call, or you can even email us.